Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I have another haul, a collective haul of ColourPop, Drugstore, and Oden's Eye. So I have the ColourPop stuff right here, and I did get two separate collections. And these are actually quite old now that I finally am getting around to filming this. I don't even know if they're still available, but I thought I would film this video anyway to show you guys what's coming into my collection, because it will soon be time to do my inventory again, and then you'll be like, when did you get all that stuff? So yeah, let's just get into it. First of all, I have these little things. I should have put them on, but Christmas is over. As you can see, I got the Rudolph collection. I actually wore these little clips. These came with the collection, by the way, if you didn't know. I wore these to my craft fair and everybody was like, oh my god, where did you get those? And I was like, actually from a makeup company, from ColourPop. And they were like, oh, like they were hoping that I would say like the dollar store or something probably, so they could get them easily. But you just clip them into your hair and they're so cute. I love them. So yeah, I wish I had filmed this video earlier, but I didn't. And anyway, this collection is not new. So you might have gotten this, was it 2 years ago that they first released this collection? I'm not sure. But I did get the whole collection because it actually wasn't that big and it looked like I would like everything in the collection. So you get these little cute ornaments of Rudolph and Clarice. So you get a lip scrub and a lip mask. Usually when I get the lip scrub and lip mask duos, I give them to my mom, but these ones, I couldn't give them up because, I already gave her like two of them, so I don't think she needs more. But if I remember correctly, these are like mint. Look how cute. That's the inside, I mean the jar. This one is the lip scrub. Yes, oh my god. Okay, anything mint, like candy cane, peppermint, spearmint, I'm obsessed with it lately. I don't know what changed. I always kind of liked it, but now I'm like, just give me everything that smells like that. And I love the ColourPop, well, the fourth ray, so it's their skincare, you know, sister brand or whatever. I love their lip scrubs because they're not just like loose sugar, it's like there's a base to it, and I love it, and this smells divine. So yeah, I need to get through, well, I'm working on a Lush lip scrub now, and then I do have other ColourPop ones I should reach for first, but I really like the smell of that. And then the lip mask has the same scent from what I remember. It has different packaging and so cute. Look at this. So look, it actually has like a color to it. So you can wear this as like a lip gloss. And it's, oh my god, it smells so good. yeah, it has the same scent. I'm not gonna put my fingers in these things yet because like I said, these, you know, they're new to my collection, obviously, and I have older ones that I need to use first. And I don't really like to, you know, contaminate products that I'm not going to open yet. But I just thought this was so cute, and I could have hung these on my tree there. But anyways, Christmas is over, so I don't know. I might just keep those boxes for something else. Like, you could put little chocolates in there and give them to somebody. I mean, it is gonna say lippy scrub on the back, but you could cover that with a sticker. I don't know. there's a lot of lip products in this collection. Actually, it's all lip products except for the eyeshadow palette. So So let's go on to the Lippy Pencil and Luxe lipstick sets. Again, you get a Rudolph and a Clarice one. So the Rudolph one is called There's Always Tomorrow. And the shade names are Rudolph. So the Rudolph Luxe Lipstick and the Rudolph Lippy Pencil. And this is so cute. That's the Lippy Pencil. This feels nice. Like, I say this every time I talk about ColourPop. Like, you wouldn't expect, because their prices are so good, that they would have such good quality. I don't know. Like, I was just talking about in my last haul, the Charlotte Tilbury. That feels cheaper than this. And this is ColourPop, so please help me understand that. But anyway, this is the Rudolph shade. It looks like a nice deep red. Oh, it's so beautiful. I did consider wearing this on Christmas, but I used what I had already. I just didn't want to open new stuff, and I was kind of like rushing around this season. So yeah, this is the Luxe Lipstick Cream, and it even has like snowflakes embossed on the bullet, if you can see that. That's so pretty. I love that color. It looks like it would be very like wine deep, you know, vampy, but it does have like a nice brightness to it, which I love for, you know, winter season. So very excited that I have that. The Clarice version is called I Think You're Cute, and this is gonna be more like your, you know, neutral. So, oh, it looks so pretty. You get another Lippy Pencil, and this one is very nude. Ooh, but I think I'm gonna love it. And the lipstick, same packaging as the Rudolph one. Ooh, yes. I think I'm really gonna like this because it is like a warmer peachy. At least from what I can tell. Or maybe it's just neutral. But it's not like a those taupe nudes that make me look like I'm sick. So I'm very excited about the shade of this. And those lipsticks feel really nice. I'm pretty sure I have other... Yes, I definitely have other ColourPop Luxe lipsticks. Because I have the Barbie ones. And I do remember liking it. It's a very smooth formula, so very excited about that. Let me remove this before I get it everywhere. As if that wasn't enough lip product, you get three Luxe lip glosses in a little set, which is so cute. I love this guy from the cartoon, or the stop motion, whatever you want to call it. That's Hermy. So you get one gloss called Hermy, one Dolly, and one Misfit Elephant, because this is the Misfits, well, the couple of Misfits trio. It's so cute. I don't know. I'm probably not gonna get rid of this packaging. So, beautiful shades. And they all have sparkle in them. So the Misfit Elephant one. Ooh, it's like this pinky one. Look at this, how cute this is. It has snowflakes on it. Ooh, smells good too. That's the applicator. And then Dolly is like a brighter kind of pink. From what I remember, these are quite sheer, so it's probably not gonna have like a big difference in the shade. And then this one's just a clear with sparkle. That's the Hermy shade. I think he's my favorite character in the... I don't know why I'm smelling all of them, because they all smell the same. But that is very fun and exciting. These are lip glosses, so they're not the lip, I think they have lip oils, right? Lux lip oil, that sounds like a product, but these are the Lux lip glosses. So yes, I do own a lot of these now, but I had to have it, it's just too cute. And then finally, the eyeshadow palette looks like this. This is called, I guess, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Yep. Pressed Powder Palette. And even on the back, like, the shades are little gifts. Like, just the attention to detail. At least when they do collabs, I feel like ColourPop is, like, really good. I don't know how else to say it. I'm just consistently impressed when I receive products from them. When I buy, like, obviously haven't received free stuff from them. I've bought everything, but when I receive it, I am reminded of how good it feels. Like, this is heavy. Why can't, you know, other brands be as good in quality of packaging? But anyway, I have swatched this, it looks like, or did it kind of get messed up in shipping? I don't know, but that's the palette, and I think it's beautiful. I feel like I'm very drawn lately to these, like, neutrals with a pop of green. That's how I feel. That's what I feel like this palette is. Yeah. I mean, there's not much color in it, except for a red and the green, but I think it looks beautiful. And, like, what else would a Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer palette color story be, right? I think it's very appropriate for the show. So yeah, I'm very excited about this. It's so cute. I'm just looking at the shade names. They're so fun. Like, Christmassy Time, Up, Up and Away, Handsome Nose, just very cute stuff. Yes, okay. So I won't get too much into it because I have another collection to show you, but that's the eyeshadow palette. So like I said, it's not new. It's new to me, obviously, but this is the second time they've released this collab. So I guess it did really well the first time. Yeah, so I got that. And then I obviously, if you have seen my other videos, you know I had to get the Sailor Moon collection because I already have the first one. Or how many collections have they done with Sailor Moon now? Is it just two? If so, I have both. Where do I begin? So, okay. Let's talk about these, the BFF Cream Gel Liners. So these are eyeliners, and I have actually used one of these in a video, which I don't remember what it was now, but it was only because the color was just exactly what I was looking for my look, and that was the shade Azabu Juban. I don't think I'm pronouncing that correctly, but it looks like this, and I will swatch it. And I did like this when I used it. It's very smooth. I think I've heard that these don't last very long, but so far, like, it's not dry or anything, and I love this color. It's like a lilac purple, and it's perfect because not recently, because I haven't been wearing much makeup throughout the holidays. I did, of course, wear makeup on Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, but other than that, like, this is the first time I'm wearing makeup. And it's New Year's Eve when I'm filming, so I don't know where I was going with that. Anyway, this one is called Crystal Tokyo, and this one is a blue. This, and I think it has shimmer in it. Yes, it's more like metallic, but look at that. That looks so pretty. I think I have another kind of shimmery blue type eyeliner that might need to get replaced with this one because it's from Essence and I've had it for literally years. So it's probably on its last leg. And it also doesn't look as like turquoise as this one. I don't know, I'll have to see it. But yeah, very happy about those two shades that we got. Then we have a Pretty Guardian. Well, the collection is called Pretty Guardian, right? I don't know. Pretty Guardian Sailor Moon, the So Dewy Face Gloss. So, I don't know if I'll use this as a face gloss. I don't know. I feel like if you wear this as a face gloss, you probably can't put much makeup underneath because it's this kind of texture and it's almost like Vaseline-y. I actually don't think I've ever tried a face gloss. I have their Glitterly Obsessed, but that's something else, right? This is meant like for the face, but I just feel like this would pull up your foundation. So I would wear this on like a gnome. Well, even today I could have worn something like this because I didn't wear foundation today. I just did like concealer. So, but it feels like Vaseline, basically. So I don't know. If it was an option, I probably would have not gotten this, but it was part of the collection, so. It is a pretty shade. It's kind of like holographic, if you can even see that. I don't know what am I trying to say? The weather is terrible. It's like nighttime, but it's only, what time is it? Well, it's 3:13, but there has not been sun for a while, it seems. So I better hurry up and finish filming this video or else it's gonna be pitch black by the end of it. But that's the little packaging. It is in a glass jar. I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you use these? The shade is Moon Crystal Power. I was thinking I might use it on the eye, but I feel like it would get very creasy, you know? Like an eye gloss kind of thing. But I just don't know what the longevity would be like. I'll just have to try it, I guess. Yeah. So let's go back to some lip products. We got two Pretty Guardian Sailor Moon Ultra Lip Duos. These are the shades. I got Celestial Powers and Heroines. And these both have an ultra glossy lip and an ultra blotted lip, which is the same as their original Sailor Moon collection. If that was the first one, I'm pretty sure the last one, there was also lip kits like this. So I love the shades of these. They're kind of unique to my collection and they just look really pretty. I don't think I should open these because we'll be here forever, but those are the shades. If you would like me to try these on in a video or something, just let me know. But again, there's too much going on here to be opening every single product. There was also two pressed powder highlighters. So these are so cute and I'll show you the packaging. So this is Moon Kingdom. And it's so cute. This is Luna, right? I don't remember. But that's the the shade. It is quite purple, but actually it looks more purple in the pan than when you swatch. It has kind of like a sheerness to it. You can see there, oh, it's very pretty. I do love colorful highlighters. I've been wearing them a lot lately, actually. I don't know if that's a popular opinion, but that's what I like. So happy to have this one, and it is like a unique-ish to my collection. And then this shade is called Moonlight, and this one has the white cat, which I can't remember the names right now. Oh, and this one might be my favorite because it's a pinky highlighter. And these are not the Super Shock formula, so they are more powdery. If you can see it there. Ooh. So they do feel like kind of dry when you swatch them, but they do have a nice shift to them. So I don't know. We'll have to see how I feel about those. Because I do really like... Well, I like the Super Shock highlighters, but I feel like I like them more when they're in the pots, like the ones in the Winnie the Pooh collection, because I have... you can't really see that, but I have a Super Shock highlighter quad from the Shell collection, like the beachy theme one. And those are... I don't feel like they're the same formula. I don't know if it's just me, but they feel more like... chunky than they do when they're in the pot. But I don't know, it may be because they're like, is there a glitter version? I'm not sure. But yeah, these are definitely the pressed powder formula. And then the eyeshadow palette, which is very cute. There's the packaging. My favorite Sailor was Sailor Jupiter. I had the doll and everything because she has brown hair and green eyes. So I guess I thought that was the one I related to the most. So this is called For Love and Justice, and it is beautiful. I believe when they launched this, they had it next to... Yes. So when they launched this collection, they relaunched the other one. And there was a bundle, I'm pretty sure, of both, but I already had the other one. But they did kind of market this to be the cool tone, like, sister of the other palette. And yeah, it just looks very pretty. I love the blues and the lavenders. Yeah, I'm gonna have fun with this one because it also has those pretty, like, this kind of shimmer that I really like. So... yeah. And I think this one twinkles. I think it's a pressed glitter, but the ColourPop pressed glitters are actually really good because they kind of stick down. Like, they're not loose, dry kind of glitter. So I think they've really improved on that formula, at least in like the ones I've seen lately. So yes, I am very excited. I think I've said that about 50 million times. But that was my ColourPop, and that was two separate orders. So, yeah, it's a lot of stuff. And now, okay, I'm getting very glittery here. But now I have a very small drugstore haul. I have my Pharmaprix bag here. If you're not from Quebec, Pharmaprix is Shoppers Drug Mart in Canada. I don't really know what possessed me to buy these things. I think I was just bored. I don't know. Well, I don't often buy drugstore products, and it's not because I'm like, ooh, I only like Sephora. It's because, first of all, I've mentioned this in a lot of videos, I feel like the prices at the drugstore are getting insane. And they are basically Sephora priced products because you get less product and it still costs a lot of money and the packaging is not as good. So, and this is speaking from a Canadian. I know in the US you guys have really good variety at your drugstores. You have a lot of different kinds of drugstores, We basically, in Quebec at least, we just have Pharmaprix and, well, Jean Coutu and like, but Pharmaprix is the one you go to for makeup, I feel, because they have, they're trying to be Ulta basically, but it's not working because we have like very small variety of brands. We actually just got, I saw on a flyer, REM Beauty, which I didn't even think that brand was sticking around, but now we have it. Anyway, I digress. But this kind of started with this product. So this is the CoverGirl Clean Color, or Clean Fresh Clean Color Eyeshadow Palette in Spiced Copper. And I've barely been liking these like CoverGirl clean products, and this looked really pretty to me, so I thought I would try it in like a drugstore try on. So if anybody cares, I can do a drugstore try on. This is like gonna be hard to open. I'm kind of rushing now because I feel like the sun is non-existent. And that is my source of light. But I just felt like this looked like a really pretty warm palette. It kind of reminds me of the Urban Decay, what is it called? Hot something? Heat? I don't know. You know which one I mean. The warm tone one. It kind of looks like that. And I kind of just was very curious about these. They do have like a lot of different ones, but I felt like this is the one that I would personally wear the most. So I did get this. And more recently, I guess, I picked up some new, well, new to me stuff from Physicians Formula. This Diamond Last. So I actually have one of these, but I have the plumping version. But then they came out with these lip cream ones. So that's the packaging. It's the same as the plumping version. I don't remember exactly. Were they just called Diamond Plump? I don't know. But I got this in the shade Rose Quartz. This also has lots of tape on it because people at the drugstore just open stuff and put it on their lips sometimes, which I've seen, and that's horrifying. But okay, I don't know if I'll be able to open this. I want to swatch it though. Ooh, that's actually really on there. That's another thing about the drugstore. When they don't tape down products, they always look like people have used them because there's no testers, right? So I sort of understand that. Like, if you want to buy something, you want to see it. But I don't know. Now it's all sticky from the tape. But let's see. I do really usually like Physicians Formula lip products, and that is a very pretty shade. So this seems to be a liquid lipstick, but it was called a lip cream. So I'm hoping it doesn't dry down like super, you know, liquid lipsticky. So I'm just gonna leave that on and we'll see what it does in the meantime. But I got that. And then I saw this Butter Glow Concealer. And I don't think I've heard anybody talk about this. It says it's new, but I don't know. I feel like these products say they're new for like years, so I'm not sure. But whenever it did come out, I guess I missed it or I wasn't paying attention. But you guys might know I am looking for concealers, and now I have two new ones to try, if you saw my last haul. But this looked kind of intriguing. It is one of these like spongy things, but I think there's two options. Yes. So you have a doe foot applicator. This looks very light. Like, oh, yeah, we'll have to see with that. That's That's the shade. It's basically wiped. But yeah, that is with the doe foot. But then I guess they're saying like you can blend it out with the sponge. I don't know if I'll do that because I feel like I would need a wet sponge for concealer, but we'll see. Does this smell like the butter bronzer? Or am I crazy? Something smells coconutty. I don't know. But I just kind of liked how this looked, and it said radiance boosting. Yeah, I did get the shade Fair to Light, and you guys know Physicians Formula. They have a terrible shade range, but also having to do with the fact that they have like one of each product in the store. So like there's no room for them to grow, I suppose. But honestly, of course they could do better, but yeah, we'll have to see about this. But I remember like just thinking this would probably be something I like. It seems more serum-y, and I just really do like the radiance boosting description, and it doesn't seem like it's shimmery or anything. It actually is looking quite nice, at least on my hand. So I am excited to try this, actually. I think this was on sale. It was most likely on sale. I try not to buy a Physicians Formula unless it's on sale because it's not very affordable. But yeah, I did get those two products. And then recently, I did see this, the e.l.f. Halo Glow Beauty Wand, the contour. So on my Sephora loves list, I have the Charlotte Tilbury one. And I never like bite the bullet and go for it because I just feel like it's so expensive and I don't really even contour, but I would probably use it as a bronzer. But then I saw this and I was like, let me just try that one and see if I even, you know, like the idea of it, I guess. I do have other of these, like, okay, everything is so hard to open, which is good, because then, like I said, people won't open it in the store. But this one I got in the shade Light Medium. What was I saying? I do have other, you know, squeezy tube type products already, but this kind of just intrigued me. So, how do you open this? Oh, it's a twist off. God. This is actually smaller than I thought it would be. Like, I don't know. The sponge tip is quite small, but we'll see. Yeah, I don't really know anything about this. What does it say? Infused with 2% squalane. Okay, that seems to be like the trending ingredient lately, squalane. But yeah, it says it's a contour. I don't know, I feel like this shade is quite warm for a contour. I'll probably just use it as a, you know, bronzer contour type thing. But yeah, it doesn't really have anything more to say about it, so it's just a cream bronzer to me. But yeah, if I end up liking this, maybe I'll try some of the other ones, because I'm pretty sure they have blush and highlighter, right, in the same like applicator. So yeah, that's another thing to try. This one is more just because it seemed to be like people were talking about those type products lately. I don't know. And I'm looking at the lip cream, which has dried down and it is basically a liquid lipstick. But it actually still retains some shine, if you can see that. But when I rub it, it's like not coming off. So that is interesting. I'll have to try that on my lips. And just the last thing I have here, I got in my stocking for Christmas. The NYX This Is Everything lip oil. I actually already have one of these that I have been using for like years. So this is a backup. I do really like this. This is more, yeah, it's a lip oil. It is very, it's not like an oily lip oil though, if that makes sense. But I really like it. So yeah, happy to have an extra one of those. And that was all like my drugstore stuff. So it's really only like four things, and then I got this for as a gift. So we'll see. I might have some other drugstore stuff in my new makeup drawer so that I could do a drugstore video if that interests anybody. I am actually very intrigued to try these things, which is why I bought them, of course. That's what happens for me when it comes to the drugstore. I don't usually like even look at the stuff there, but every once in a while I see something new or that looks like it could be good, and then I really want to try it and see how it is. So more to come on that, I guess. And that is not coming off. Okay, it's getting very dark, but I do have one more package from Oden's Eye, and it's this here. I did get the new Christmas collection. So, I don't even know if this is still available, but if you guys saw, when they came out with this, they re-released the old one, which was supposedly discontinued. So, I don't know. Maybe it just depends like how well they sell. If there's like high demand, they'll bring it back if it's not still available. But yeah, I'm not sure. Anyway, it came with these scarves like they normally do. They come with a little something extra and they're very cute. I don't know what I'll do with them, but they're like the art from the palette. So this is the snowman one. It's so cute. I have actually used these like in my hair, but really not when I'm like when I'm filming something related to Oden's Eye. You know, I don't know, but you could like tie gifts with these. You could tie them on your bags. You could do different stuff with them, I suppose. And then this one is the reindeer. Oh, so cute. So those just came with the bundle, which was the two eyeshadow palettes that I will show you now. So I got the Snow Dream palette, and I do have the original Christmas, the Christmas and the Christmas Eve palette, is that what they were? And have I used them yet? No. But I got these. I just love Oden's Eye. Like everything about it. The colors, the formulas, like the packaging, how they lay everything out. It's just very attractive to me. So this is the Snowman palette, like I said. It has, you know, your red and green Christmassy colors, but it also has like these fun colors. This like, that looks very light on camera because of my lighting, but it's more like, I don't know, yellowy. And you got purple. You have like pretty much everything you could want. And you do have lights and like deeper shades too, so that's fun. So that is something I need to try. The Snow Dream palette, is that, did I say Snowman palette? It's the Snow Dream palette. And then there is the Hey Reindeer palette. And if you guys want, I can do video on these, like swatches and everything, or like looks, like I did with the Halloween collection. So this one is more, what is it more? Because there was Boom Purple in the other one too. I don't know, it's more blue and orange and purple. I don't know, but I love it. So You have different formulas in these palettes. Some of them are duochromes from what I recall. And yeah, I just think I've liked every palette I've tried from Oden's Eye. So, and the colors, like, even though I now own, like, almost all of their palettes. Like, well, other than the new one, the old ones. Well, the very old ones, I guess. Because 1 year I got a mystery box and it was ginormous. So I now own, like, a lot of things from Oden's Eye. But even, like, the point of my story is even though I own so many Oden's Eye, I feel like every palette is unique in itself. Like, they don't, you know, seem to dupe themselves a lot. So, yeah. I just love them as a brand. And their shipping is really good. You get a tracking number. It ships from China, from Hong Kong, actually, I believe. Is that what it said? But it's like a Swedish brand, but they ship from there. And even though it's from Hong Kong, like, it gets here more quicker and, like, better tracking than if I order something from, like, my own city. So, I don't know what that's about. But they seem to be very well organized, and I just like to support them. So, yes, I will definitely be getting more of their stuff. I just have to use what I own already, of course. So, yeah, that is my haul. My collective haul, and that is everything, I think. There was one more thing I wanted to get from Sephora. I wanted to buy it today when I bought some other things, but it was out of stock. It's the new lipstick from Makeup by Mario. So that might be coming at some point, but other than that, I think this is enough makeup. Yeah. This should be my last, like, haul for a little while, and then we're gonna get into more, like, actually using products again. Because I do, well, like I said before, it's New Year's Eve when I'm filming this, so I will have new, like, intros to projects coming. Yeah, I haven't really organized myself yet, but that will be coming. So, yeah. I hope you liked this video. I think that's all I have to say. If you did, give it a like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!